Oh, boy.
Oh, the straps are down.
How about that?
Let's put him up.
First time we've seen that. He dared him to hit him, and he did. Backhand chop and right hand. And another one. Down goes Jarrett. Right hand.
Look at the nature boy.
Jarrett's wobbly in the corner. Combination blows by Flair. Here he goes again.
The nature boy has not lost a step.
And he had a message for Debra.
And Ric Flair now.
This camera had better be on me because it is time. Oh. I explained why I did what I did last night. And I can tell you one thing. I am so sick and tired of living in Steve McMichael's shadow. I am tired of it. Try living with a famous person for a while. It is not a picnic. Tell you what, he has been an all-pro defensive tackle of the Chicago Bears. And he has been a Super Bowl winner. But the key word is has been. And I am sick and tired of dealing with
so let him hammer this out.
Wow. Get the figure four on
him. The figure four is on. And here we go. The Horseman are out. The match is over. Disqualification. But I don't think that's the motive here, guys.
No.
This is what they've wanted to do for Jarrett for a long time.
Payback time. It's teach a lesson to Jeff Jarrett. And the Horsemen are back and meaner than ever.
This is what happens when you fool around with the Horsemen. And especially when you do this to a man. Mongo snapped.
Well, sure, you make him sleep on the couch all night. The man will be stark raving mad when he gets his hands on Jarrett.
Jarrett's running away. Debra's there. You notice Kurt Hennig got the offer from Flair, but he did not come out at all. So there are still only three right now.
And see Mongo McMichael was a man possessed.
And this is only the beginning of what Jarrett is going to have to endure at the hands of the Horsemen, guys. You can take that one to the bank.
Horsemen obviously have a plan for Jarrett. That was chapter one.
Earlier, Benoit said, I'm going to help take care of Horseman business. He just did. Back with more live on Nitro.